Ready, Sean?
Are you ready?
No.
You're leading, remember?
Hello, and welcome to the first ever DML podcast.
Oh, boy.
And maybe the last. We'll see. Normal videos on our channel will still be going out, don't worry, to our YouTube viewers. In fact, some of these might be even turned into edited videos to kind of fact check us maybe a little bit. Because at the end of the day, we're just talking.
Sure. Uncharted territory.
We're not sure how consistent we'll be. It's kind of like dependent on how much news there is, you know, make videos. So if there's a lot of news in 1 week, then we could have a podcast. Or if it's so small, maybe it's not worth making a video about.
Yeah, we've really hit the off season, right?
Yeah. And that's what a time to start a podcast for
So much to talk about.
In fact, we're looking at old stuff in this podcast. There are literally so many other great Ducks podcasts or other hockey podcasts in general. So we thought we could bring something unique. People have asked us to start one, so we figured why not try it? But yeah, well, this is kind of a way to maybe bring on guests in the future, kind of give the channel a more professional feel, even though it's definitely not professional.
Professionally unprofessional, you might say.
There you go, Sean. There you go. In general, you could actually ask us questions, hockey related or not, maybe down in the future.
Yeah, duck calls.
Duck calls. Oh, yeah. Bring it back. There we go.
Unmoderated duck calls.
Better than the duck stream one right now.
Yeah.
Since it's our first one, and we haven't introduced ourselves in a while because it's been almost like 2 years since we made the welcome to our video channel.
How many subscribers later?
That's probably like 10,000 subscribers since then. Yeah. So I figure since the first one, we're introduced ourselves again. I'll let Sean go first because I kind of play off him a little bit.
Kim already said, introduce me. I'm the big brother. My name's Sean. Start off just saying like how we got into hockey, how we started liking the Ducks. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I didn't grow up liking hockey really. It started because our family was like big Angels fans. And back when Disney owned both the Angels and the Ducks, the Angels had this thing where you could take your ticket over to the Ducks arena to watch the rest of the Ducks game. And then one game happened, and then I remember going to games with my mom and thinking that every Angels game we went to, we would be going to the Ducks game after, and unfortunately, that's not how it worked. But then my mom started buying, like, group tickets or the season plans or whatever for those, and eventually we started going to more Ducks games than Angels games.
I feel like you're forgetting your first hockey game.
Oh, I mean, there was the Ice Dogs before that. Okay, my dad got me into that. That was something that we did. I actually have a little throwback, maybe. I don't know how well you guys will be able to see this, but there's young Sean and the Pops at the Ice Dogs games.
I guess, would your Mariners win, Sean? That's what popped up.
No. They're down by one. Yeah, now I'm a Mariners fan, but that's a whole nother podcast to get into.
Brutal.
And family trauma and all that. So, yeah. Go ahead, Jim.
That's about it. So, I was forced to go to these Ice Dogs games Sean used to go to, and I remembered hating it a lot. And the funnest part was throwing the puck on the ice for Chuck-a-puck. That's the only thing I remember. Bunch of cold seats. But then, yeah, I still hated it. And then Sean used to go to the Ducks game. And I think my uncle bought, like, these things for Christmas.
Yeah.
And I don't think I actually went to that because I didn't want to go because I hated going to hockey games. So I think I gave
my ticket. How old were you?
10?
10.
10, 12, maybe. I don't know. Something like that. And then I gave my ticket to, like, my cousin's boyfriend at the time, I think. So I didn't go. And then one time you couldn't go to a game, so I was forced to go to a Ducks game, and I loved it.
Oh,
so it took, the third time was the charm on this one.
Do you remember the game?
No, I probably have the ticket somewhere. That'd be kind of cool. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's basically it. And then
I remember one of the games, and I think you were there. It was, we were like sitting behind the net, and we were on the good side, but it was overtime, and Lubomir Vyshnovsky, nasty left-handed shot. He scored like the OT winner with like point something left. And I wonder if it's that game. Because like we were all like so pumped. And like seeing that game, how can you not like become a hockey fan after that?
Well, there you go. It's because of a, how do we say his name again? Lubo. There you go. I can't say his last name.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's about it. And then also, I guess my mom and I became season ticket holders in like 2015.
Huh, there was also like a coincidence, maybe.
Coincidence, yeah.
I moved up to the Bay Area and then they decided to get Ducks season tickets. Huh.
Well, funny.
I was just.
A little cheaper.
I was such a cash strain for them, apparently.
Two versus three. But yeah, since then, yeah, been pretty big Ducks fan. So working on, I'd say, 10 years plus of following the Ducks, basically.
Yeah. Yeah. Probably got like another
5 years.
At least.
All right. But I think that's about our hockey story. Okay. So the next thing, it's dead off season, nothing to talk about. And it's something that's been on the video list for a while. And honestly, I just procrastinated ever doing it because it sounded like a lot of work to get all these clips of every single player that played with the Ducks last season. Whoa. So here it is, the way too late players grades of the 2023-24 off season. It's off season right now.
I'm going to watch a season recap before this.
So. Oh, yeah. Let's watch my season recap.
On my Instagram. Pull up the
email. So, yeah. Hopefully we're number enough. Either way, we'll just kind of do the best at grading them. I don't know.
Oh, I can't wait to get roasted.
Here we go. So, we're each just going to pick one. You want to start or you want me to start?
Ladies first. Come on. You're the head dog here. Let's you start.
Well, I think I got the easiest one. I don't even need to, like, talk about this guy. Only F, probably, of the whole list.
Goodness.
Ross Johnston, a pickup.
Only F is pretty optimistic for this list, I think.
Oh, man, what are Sean's thoughts? But yeah, so F, I mean...
Do we get to debate? Or is it? I don't have anything to debate on this one. I'm just talking about future ones.
For sure, we can debate. In fairness to him, his role was to be a fighter. And I found out he had 9 fights on the year.
Like, how does the NHL... That's all fights now. Like
that's top five fighter in the league. But at the same time, I can't remember a single one of his fights.
I feel like they put hands on each other. The ref breaks it up immediately. Does that count as a fight? Like how?
Yeah, I don't know how that works. But
is fighting is that just a fighting major? Because like those are thrown around.
That's probably too. But yeah. Anyway, fighter didn't fight, or he sucked at fighting, and he just took up roster space.
I feel like there's got to be another category, which is just like don't care, like not applicable.
We can do NA. We can just leave him down there for something like that, I guess.
Well, I guess you're taking that side of the spectrum. I'll take the other side of the spectrum and go Frank the Tank.
Do it.
Career year.
All-star.
That'd be interesting to look at. I don't even know. Like, did any other player like actually have a career year on the Ducks? Like everyone else was below their numbers or...
I don't think anyone else did. Mm-hmm. No. A lot of people had career years last year, yeah.
So yeah, Frankie, if there was an S tier, that's where he would be. But he is in the tippy top of the A, for sure.
The only thing I will say is that his defense, a lot of times outweighed his offense. But at the same time, you're leading the team in points. You have to break out you have to be A.
Yeah.
So, easy enough.
He also was the only player to play 82 games, which is impressive in itself.
Let's see if Kimmy going with her heart or is he going with some logic?
We'll just get the favorite player Timmy out of the way. He's gonna be in C. Wait, it's I know people are gonna.
Yeah,
Sean's got to beat me on this one. Okay,
you put it where you think.
Okay,
and there is no way he should be a C, but go ahead.
Okay, if I look at the stats, he is still second on the team points wise.
He also played the most games in his career, which is saying something in a season where everyone was hurt.
Obviously, you expected more, but like...
After signing for $7 million, you kind of...
You're going to be out by the guy in,
two, three or something.
You don't think it should be in C, huh?
I'm fine. This could be a dynamic list, but so, I think just if we're going off of like expectations, maybe it's just expectations before the season. I was expecting a ton more, and that's why I'm so hurt by Timmy.
Now, easily, next season, he does the same thing.
Well, he might be out.
Yeah, he might be an F. But right now, we'll just say C.
Maybe I go with my heart, too, and we'll go a little Dostal. I'm putting Dostal in A, too.
I agree.
Great. Another great season. Really excited to see him maybe get some more games this next season, more closely split in time, maybe even get a little bit more time.
We got a kitty. She's going to come join.
Sorry. My cat is meowing.
Good to see you.
Nope, she doesn't want to come, but she's just yelling at me. So.
Yeah, I agree. He did all we can really do when your Ducks defense sucks.
Yeah.
So him and Gibby got to be fighting for the starting role. That'll be interesting. Why don't we talk about Gibby while we're at it? It's a very controversial one. I feel like if I give Terry a C.
That's what I was saying.
Yeah, I give Gibby
that's
a
what
C.
That's what I was saying. Like, Timmy is like the barometer right now.
Like, he sets the standard.
Yeah. And it's like, was he worse than Terry? How many people are going to fall above worse than Terry?
Honestly, I don't know. This is the first year I kind of got like semi-tired of Gibby. Like, he always has that laid-back attitude. But like, this year I was like, geez, come on, bro. He could have tried. Maybe he wouldn't have saved it. But just like, try. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, that's his personality, though, but just with all the other stuff, trade rumors and stuff going on.
For years.
He always lets in those, like, soft ones, you feel. All right, I guess my turn, huh? Let's see, who do I want to do next? I guess I'll do Strome, and I think this is, I think he is below the Timmy line. He is in the D. Yeah, I just feel like he's, I mean, kind of like Timmy, not living up to the contract he got, the expectations, and I guess you could say he started out well, really but not. I mean, he was kind of getting, I feel like he was getting carried by the McTee-Vetrana line.
Yeah.
And then towards the end, like, I feel like...
Yeah, nothing. There was a... yeah. I think there was some stat where I think he had, like, 4 points the rest, like, in the second half of the season. So all these points are basically all first half or something like that. Something weird like that. Like, it wasn't a lot in the second half. That's mm-hmm. that's silly. So, yeah, I agree with the D. This could be an interesting one. You look at his first half.
Lauren F? Maybe D?
Easily, I think. Then he had surgery. Yeah. Man, I put Timmy in C.
No, that, you might need to change that one.
But above Strom. Okay. There can't be worse than Strom.
Yeah, that's fair. So I was going to say, like, you just got to be a B if Timmy is a C.
He almost could be a B, I guess. But I don't know.
He's borderline.
He's borderline B. I guess I'll put him in C and move Terry down to D. His second half of the season was really good.
Yeah.
So if he can continue that, he could definitely be a good player and good signing by Beaker. We'll just see if he was or not.
Yeah. And just the experience he brings. Hopefully he's teaching the young guys good stuff. But
I was unimpressed with his leadership, I will say, during the season.
All right, I'll do Minty. You know, I love me some Minty. I mean, A?
It's between the two, and I
feel like he's got it.
Dosti an A, you got to give Minty. I mean,
yeah, I just feel like Minty, like, kind of was a surprise this season. Expected him to be good, but not as good as he was.
Not even be actually on the Ducks lineup.
Yeah.
He started off really strong, got injured, and then kind of never got back to his beginning level, but, I mean, overall, his whole season was great. Didn't get any votes for the Calder, or, like, one or two or three, you know, it's not very many.
So, you get any. You got somebody to know that.
He wasn't in top five, let's just say that. Leo, I think it's an A. There was questions if he would even be with the Ducks. He'd go back to the SHL. Mm-hmm. He started off strong. He has said himself that he's not overall happy with the season, because he kind of had some bad games every once in a while.
Yeah.
Didn't put up points. He had injuries. Trouble hitting the net. He came back from three different knee injuries.
Mm-hmm. And you just tell when he was on the ice.
Every time he was on the ice, he did something, even though his teammates weren't ready for his passes most of the time.
Man, this A, I'm actually might be putting more players into this A than I was expecting. But
we're talking about, like, your expectations. What were your expectations versus what they actually did, right? Kind of like that's my thought process.
I might put, like, Udis up it.
Oh, yeah. That's easy.
Just leadership. He was, like, one of the most fun players to watch when he was on the ice, and he's got the hip checks. So that's, like, one of my favorites. So definitely in the A, future captain, Radko Gudas.
And he also, I think, led the Ducks defense in goals.
Well, wait for Zelly to maybe take that one.
Zelly's coming up next year. All right. McTavish. Okay. He started off.
All-star first half.
Yeah, he started off almost like a 100-point pace of the first mm-hmm. half. Then he got hurt. You can obviously tell his line mates, he was carrying his whole line with Frankie and Strom. So I think solid B, expected more from him. But it's hard to tell because he was hurt.
I guess we were saying that Kaloran was on that Stroudland, that BC line. Then I think the same thing for McTavish. And probably more on the B side than the C side.
I guess you could say B plus or something.
He's got, like, one of the most memorable moments of the season for me, that out-of-the-box winner.
So good.
That was so cool.
And he has a big contract here. Mm-hmm. See what happens this year.
All right. Let's get the hate out of the way. Cam Fowler. Not put in a position to succeed, for sure, but still probably his worst season in the NHL, so he has to go in F, I feel.
Whoa! You're going to get a lot of people loving you, and then quite a few people hating you.
I mean, D or F. I mean, come on. Like,
if Terry is in D, mm-hmm. Fowler has to be F. But yeah, like Sean said, he really was not put in his position to succeed. He needs to be second pair, third pair next year. What was his plus minus? I know, which doesn't matter, but at the same time, it's like...
To the bottom.
Literally, the bottom. And with his D partner. So I don't know. Maybe Jackson Lacombe had something to do. Since I said his name, we'll do Jackson Lacombe. People are going to get mad about this one. At the same time, I don't think he was put in a position to succeed playing on his off wing with Fowler. And the times he wasn't with Fowler, with, like, Gudas, he actually looked pretty good.
Like, Cam was more kind of the Cam's offensive-minded, so when Jackson Lacombe's not playing with someone that's offensive-minded, like, he could be that person.
Mm-hmm.
And so he jumped in on the rush, I feel like, when he wasn't playing with Fowler. More C, but yeah, but I'm not mad at B, but I feel like...
B-minus.
Yeah, I feel like he was just...
You'll have the minuses, but...
Yeah, he was part of the Ducks' defense, so where were you going to put somebody up higher? Let's do Rico, and I think Rico's got to be in the B. Could be in the.
He could be. I think he's above. For sure.
But Lacombe for sure. But yeah, just really missed him going. You know, it was going to happen, but he was just always solid and just really good guy.
Yeah, our team really missed his faceoffs. That's for sure. He's been with the team for 6 years. It's hard to believe he was there that long. But yeah, definitely miss him. Good luck to him in Edmonton. He signed a 2-year deal there with his new baby and family. So we'll go with Connor McDavid, a.k.a. Leeson. Leeson should have got more ice time than he did.
Yeah.
But I think a B, he was anywhere he was put, he played good.
Just for his role.
Yeah.
Obviously not, didn't have better years than some of these guys, but just for his
role.
Expectations and what he was... what he was put in the lineup to do, like he did it.
Now we're getting down to the nitty gritty.
Yeah,
some big names still left.
Well, let's do Zelly. I feel like Zelly's also another BC guy for me. Probably put him in B though, just because I feel like he did get better. I feel like he kind of got when he first started playing, he was getting pushed around quite a bit. But I feel like he kind of made some changes to be a little bit more physical, and the offensive ability and skating ability is definitely there. So I'm excited to see what he does in the next season.
Played 26 games in the NHL, but he was an all-star in the AHL. So he looked really good down there. Mm-hmm. So hopefully he can bring that more regularly next year. Go with Uro. Honestly, I expected nothing from him. And
maybe not even making the roster.
I didn't even see a future with us with him at all. But him and Gudas, top five D pairing the league. Every night he looked good and he stayed healthy and scored his first NHL goal. Another highlight of the season.
We'll take the big name off the board. Z. really hard to judge his season just because he was like injured for so much of it, which is why, yeah, I was thinking C just because. I mean, Z definitely in the games he played.
When he was healthy.
Better
he looked like an A. He looks like an A player in the last 10 games. Looked like an A player.
I feel like this season, I feel like it was just like a wash for him, just because of injuries and the games that he did play. Probably still injured. So next season is okay. Wait and see next season. What's he gonna do? Because this season was just like a lot of the players just unlucky with injuries, but him specifically.
Big step up in his defensive game.
That's true.
And yeah, he needs to show something this year because. Trade talk is getting tiring, man.
Yeah.
All right. Well, why don't we go with the B?
The couple.
F-R-I-P couple. I can't even really judge Dane. I mean, like.
I don't remember his games.
He had a goal. I'll just put him there. You know, he was great.
They stay in the tier list together.
But, like, in Philly, they got really happy about him, and then all of a sudden he got hurt again. So, wish him the best in Philly.
Okay, I will go my favorite Twitch streamer. Maximilian Joneses. It was a very amazing intro for a not so stellar season, unfortunately, off the Boston. But yeah, I'd put him in the D. He's just like a better version of Nick Ritchie.
I agree.
Big guy. There is a lot of potential, but he just never really seemed to put it together. He had glimpses, including this past season where he looked
2-week stretch. He looked insane.
Mm-hmm.
And then injuries all year. So I think he's a better version of Nick Ritchie, but a more injury-prone version of Nick Ritchie.
And probably many more IQ points than Nick Ritchie.
Let's go with the 2024-25 Calder winner, Cutter Gauthier.
I mean, he only played one game. You got a point.
Goal per game.
Honestly, it's more just based on watching him from development camp. He looks so good. Mm-hmm. So, but, I mean, simple enough. 1.1 game.
All right, we'll go with Jakob Silverberg. I mean, probably his last season. They can't be too hard. I'll put a B.
And I don't think he should be there, but because it is last season, he needs to be in B at least. Yeah. Like
one of the greatest moments of the season was the last game where picture on the ice with him and his family and just the send off that the crowd gave him. He's been on the Ducks basically his whole career. Huge part of those playoff runs with that Cogs Kessler line and just a super fun player. I love like really good forechecking players, and yeah, he's one of the best at that.
You know, offensively, his game was gone. Defensively, he's always been strong. In this season, he was still one of the best defensive players in the whole league. So good for him. Obviously, wasn't worth his contract, but
Okay. I was waiting for that one. Well, I was saving it for you.
Bone Brew. He goes F. He didn't score a single.
I thought you were done. Just put him on there and then my turn. Upset.
He is now with the New York Rangers. I don't know how he got another contract. He has one empty net goal his whole career. Goodbye. Hot man, though.
Let's see. I'll stick with the Swedes. Lundy thing gets a C. I mean, he's honestly like a lot of the things that we said about Silf. Besides Uitari and all that, that you could say about him. He's great defensively, but he really hasn't put it together offensively. Not this past season. And maybe, was it the season before that where he was like showing glimpses of some offense?
Like every year he shows some glimpses, but just not. What do you expect?
Still a useful kind of checking player. Still really good defensively. Was not blown away. Was not disappointed, really. He's just kind of one of those guys on the ice, just responsible player for the most part.
That's why I get him out of the way, too.
Robert Hagg.
This guy thought he was going to get an NHL job, complained about it to the media about how he's stuck in the AHL, and guess what he does? He goes get another contract with the Knights for the AHL.
Why did Dukes want me? They brought up all these young players instead. Yeah, because he did better than you.
Like Zelly took his job.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's go with another departure during the season. Big Dick Carrick. For the vibes alone, B. He's just a
utility player. Does everything.
Literally does everything.
And fights.
And fights, yeah.
Face-offs were huge. I definitely wish we could have kept him for a fourth line. He's a great fourth line player. All right.
There we go. We're getting to like he played like under five games.
Might not even talk about some of them.
Yeah.
Brock McGinn, who surprisingly, I think, played 26 games for the Ducks. Do you remember that at all?
Nope.
Actually, let's look at the stats because I'm curious now.
I remember that Ducks like highlight video they posted on.
I saw he was.
It was part of the highlights for the season or the NHL.
NHL posted a top 10 play of the Ducks, and he was one of the goals. I was like,
even though like it was nothing that.
That's his goal. There it is. Yeah. One goal. He played 24 games and had three points. That's not his role. He's like fourth liner, but I mean, if he stays healthy, he looked decent in his games. This is last year. He's not going to be back with the Ducks.
So. Yeah, I just think we got a lot of players that I think I'd rather see get in ice time. Brock McGinn. I'll do Tristan Lanneau. Kind of a surprise for me this season.
He only played like three games because of his knee. He's going to play more. Then he got sent to World Juniors. Couldn't play because of his knee infection. But I think he makes the Ducks next year. And honestly, he looked better.
Didn't really know much of him going into the season, and he exceeded expectations that I had. So
honestly, that was close to an A.
I'd put him in B just because small sample size. We didn't see what the league got to make adjustments against him. So, and the one that Kimmy has wrong.
I'm sorry, gummy bear, Ilya Ovechkin. I hope you stay, but you didn't. I thought he looked pretty good, and honestly, he got better when he went to Toronto. So I think it was just the Ducks. But he really helped Minty really grow into his role, a Russian brother from another mother.
Yeah.
So I think I'd put him in B.
You want to do the rest of these?
Okay.
Sam Colangelo.
He looked good.
I thought he looked good.
I gave him A for his game he played.
Yeah.
And the Kia Nestorenko I thought looked pretty good in his games. Mm-hmm. And you're comparing him to Regenda, who's fighting a role for, I'd say he looked much better than Regenda. So Regenda D, Nestorenko B.
Is that Lagesson?
Yeah, Lagesson.
Looked pretty good for C.
I really liked Lindstrom, to be honest with you. It's a righty. We got Ben Myers, who we traded for, and now is somewhere else with a waste of a pick.
D.
Does it even belong? Yeah, sure.
Well, Stalock, honestly, he never played.
He
was a backup, but he looked a bit terrible for the goals, too.
So F.
Well, I forgot your name. Oh, well. He played, Glenn Godwin. He played three games for the Ducks, actually, somehow. And I don't know. I don't remember. I'm putting him to D.
I don't
because he's better than these folks, but yeah, that's it. That is our way too late player grade. Hopefully some of what we said made sense.
Let us know if you agree or disagree in the comments down below.
Definitely keep the comments coming on this one. It'll be interesting for sure. But anyway, that's kind of our first ever podcast. Wasn't too bad. It was a little...
I think we kind of hit our stride there in a little bit and maybe missed a step here or there. But first one down, let us know if this is even something that you want to see another one of or if this just like destroyed the channel. Yeah, let's let
and
us
also,
know.
We'll probably never be like we are this time.
Yeah, we're in person together.
Maybe once, maybe again, but
this podcast will be anywhere you listen to coming soon. Apple is taking a little bit longer on the podcast, but If you enjoyed the video, as always, like and subscribe, or follow, I guess, in this case. Thank you for listening, and
I guess thank you for watching, and go, Ducks! Duck my life, DML, passion's high, in Orange Country, let's fly!